Leo ninamueleza kuhusu huyu Steve. Sio mtu wa kucheza na pia sio mvivu. Ni mtu mwenye kuwaza mbele asitoke kavu. Ni mfano wa kuigwa kwa vijana chipukizi.
My name is Steven Otoi. I'm 23 years old. I'm from Gersen, that is entire Tana River County under Delta, Tana Delta District, where the inhabitants of Gersen Division, we have predominantly invaded by Ormas, Okomo. Through all the challenges that we get in Gersen, among them being tribal conflicts, being gender-based violence, among many challenges that we face in Tana Delta.
My name is Majina Masezi, and I'm one of the project supervisors of the Kilifi ICS program being implemented through VSO agency. And we've been in Kilifi for the past 1 year. And just to say something small about Steve, who was among the volunteers from the first cycle, literally the cycle that started the program in Kilifi. Steve was a very, very hardworking young man. He was also working partly in a special school. We say special school, but here in Kilifi we call them special units. So a special unit is a unit where we have children with disabilities. And that was something he had not done before. So it was good just to place him in those experiences.
I happened to host volunteers from September to December last year. That is 2012. The boys that I was hosting were Steve, we had Herbert and Matt. Narrowing down to Steve showed a lot of leadership skills in his ability of doing tasks and all that. We were able to do a number of activities together. Going to the field, he was able to take up actions and things that were given to him to do very well. We are very, very much proud of you. We are very much proud of what you have done to the community and the society at large. Well done, and keep it up. Keep up the spirit of working as a community member and bringing up the changes in the society.
During the period of 3 months I was with Stephen here, he worked tirelessly, he worked fully. Among the activities he did was making of teaching learning aids. He painted walls and left very beautiful talking walls. Bronze Years, which is a magazine which is talking about disability rights. He also started a smart club. Smart club, which is teaching learners social skills. Participated very well in games and sports, and even took our children to Mombasa. Started a kitchen garden where we planted bananas, and there are bananas now about to be ready. Stephen was a very innovative person. Steven was a wonderful man, hardworking, who has promoted special needs education in our unit. He also taught poems to our learners, and the purpose of these poems were to create awareness. The poem was even represented in our conference, disability conference, on 27th October. In Nairobi. Stephen is a very kind man, innovative, imaginative. I wish him success in his future endeavors.
My name is David Kashindo. I'm the project coordinator at Mwangaza Orphanage. Mwangaza came to birth in the year 2009, of which we only had 11 children. We now have 41 kids. Our really aim in Mwangaza is to give the kids a better future. That is food, nutrition, shelter, and good care, and also most to the prayer is education, so they can have or be the future of tomorrow. And mostly I'd like to say thank you to Steve, who normally comes here and helps out with the kids' chaos, playing and understanding the kids. That is what the kids really need. As you can see, the kids are really happy, and we've really expanded till then. Right now, we are trying to build like more relationship within the community. We want to integrate the community into Mwangaza, so that it's not just an institution, but more of a home. He's been really helpful with information and about kids, and he's really also good at kids because I've seen him play with them. I've seen him like tend to kids. He's really a good guy. He tenders and has attention for kids. And the work he's done is really a good one, or whatever he's doing is a really a good work, because attending to kids, most people don't really bother about kids. What they do is just see them on the street and not bother about them. But I've seen Steve to be somebody who really cares about children.
Nafurahia, naenjoy, jeza na kuimba. Nimefurahia hata wageni waliokuja.
Nimefurahia kucheza na wageni waliokuja katika Mwangaza. Tumecheza nao nikafurahia, kaenjoy.
My zeal and my hope and my vision in future is that I want to see a community where people being proactive, people taking different responsibility, taking different roles in the society.
Steve, apart from him being hardworking, is also throughout the program he acted as, I call him resolution manager. He was very good at conflict management. So like every time the team had issues, and it was a very big team, so he had a team of 16 volunteers. That was 6 from the UK and 10 from Kenya. So Steve was among the Kenyan volunteers from Garsen. And every time the team had team dynamics, which is something that happens when you have a big group of volunteers coming from different backgrounds, Steve would come to the group, you know, make them put the issues on the table, make them settle them. And at the end of the day, people will be back to, you know, working as a team. And so clearly I can say it's been good. It's been a good experience working with Steve. As much as I'm a project supervisor, there are times when I felt I could even step back and still know that things would work out. You know, all I had to do is just pick my call Steve, and everything would be okay, including the other volunteers. He's a very good team player. So in the scenario of football, he can really dribble well and ensure there's a goal that has been scored. And he's very good at well in negotiation and communication skills, very, very strong skills. There was a time, I know, even when the team had to, like, you know, plan events or negotiate for things, he would always step in to negotiate for even food if they're planning team activities, or even if they wanted to run community action days or trainings for the team.
I've been working with also trying to see how to help volunteer, also trying to learn how project supervising entailed. Thanks to Magina and Nadina, who have been close to me, trying to help me to nurture the skills of project supervising. And it has been fun for me, at the same time learning point, of course. And I'm looking forward to go back to my community after this and try to see how I can achieve more and more things to come in future.
My name is Hira. I'm one of the volunteers from England for VSO ICS. And for the last 10 weeks, I've had the opportunity to work with Steve. And I can easily say that he's one of the most easygoing people that I've met so far in Kenya. He's helped us a lot, and he's definitely been the building gap between us and the supervisors. I think it's brilliant that Steve has actually gone through the process himself, and then he can share his experience, and he can also tell us about how to like tackle the problems, and maybe like what to expect from the program and what to look forward to in the future. And I think he's also given the like eye-opening to the Kenyan volunteers about what can happen after the VSO is finished. I think it's really nice to have someone like him, because we can relate to him, and I think supervisors can also relate to him, so it definitely helps to have someone like him in the program.
I've met different people in my life which at the end of the day they have added something in my life, and I believe also I've added something in their life.
Kwa majina naitwa Abdul, natokea Kwale County. Nimekuwa katika VSO na kwa muda wa takriban miezi miwili hivi naweza sema. Steve ni kama project supervisor wetu, anafanya kazi kwa bidii, amenisaidia kiupande wangu kwa hali ya kuwa nilipokuwa sisikii vizuri, kwa kuwa nilikuwa nataka kufanyiwa operation, then nilikataa kwa kuwa nilihofia maisha yangu, lakini Steve alikuwa mstari wa mbele kwangu kuhakikisha kwamba ninaweza kufanyiwa ile huduma kulingana na vile ambavyo nilikuwa sitaki.
In this program also I learned how to integrate, I learned to meet different people and to grow together. But at the end of the day when I finished the program, I was a whole person. And first of all I was thinking, how could I integrate whatever I've learned to go and share out with my community? It was a huge challenge for me because I was like asking myself, who gonna understand me? Who is going to like kind of join hands with me? But I thank also VSO because when I went home, we had a kind of home quick action project which entailed the youth structure. So we quickly went home and started a project that deals with youth structure. We basically, it was about forming a youth structure from district level, from county level to the grassroots, where basically we found that many youths lack information, many people lack information, and I think information is one of the basic need that one needs to know what is happening. And I think also some youths, they don't get to do what they're supposed to do because they lack information at one point. We formed a magnet theater which was there before, but it wasn't working well. Now, joining hands with other volunteers and with other like-minded youths, we formed this magnet theater, a network that now, as we speak, is working with Afia Plus, and its main function is to teach the community through laughter. So they do drama, they do different kind of activity, outreaches to the community, they talk about HIV awareness, they talk about early marriages, they talk about gender-based violence and many, to mention a few. Staying in Kilifi and working in Kilifi around my placement, around volunteering, staying with the host home, I felt that that I can live anywhere in this world, I can live anywhere, integrate with other people in this life.
We also stayed committed to the program throughout the 3 months, as much as there are so many challenges in placements, because sometimes placements don't really know how to make good use of volunteers. But as long as we kept encouraging him, he kept finding his role. And at the end of the day, I think at the end of those 3 months, there was so much to see. Again, during the program, Steve was working with a UK counterpart. Her name was Grace Beards. If only she was here, you'd have had the experience. But they worked very well as a counterpart pair. Again, you can imagine people coming from different backgrounds, with totally different experiences, one from the UK, one from Kenya, and you know, this time around it's Garrison. And also at that time, Garrison really had conflicts in the community, but still Steve stood strong. They worked very well with the counterpart. Sometimes, like I said, there are team issues between the UK and the Kenyans. Steve and the counterpart will stay in the middle or stick in the middle and make sure they brought everyone together. So I am very confident, and right now I know he's, you know, going higher in the ladder, and he's going to get higher. I always encourage him that what he learned throughout the program, we call it invaluable experiences. And sometimes you cannot really measure what you gain or what a person gain. But I can confidently say that Steve has gained a lot and he keeps using. Steve has even been nominated for some awards. I know there's this award that they call Waliobobea Awards, which is nomination for persons who have stood up to fight for the rights, or rather I will say human rights of people in this community. So for this aspect I'm talking about Garrison community. And I know also in the VSO program he's also been nominated, not even nominated, he actually won the best ICS volunteer alumni up to now, because right now we're in cycle 5.
So I urge all the Kenyan volunteers now who are in the, who are volunteering with VSO, to take this initiative that volunteering period is a period where you have to learn new things and focus on what you have to gain as a long-term skills. So how best can you use those skills that you are volunteering in to make sure that you help or you get something that you want in life?
Tamati zangu kongole hatua alizopiga, na kuomba usilale safari bado ni changa. Ni mfano wa kuigwa kwa vijana chipukizi.